James Vincent, an absolute honour to grab a couple of minutes with you before probably one of the most exciting nights of your career.
Yeah, yeah, I guess it is in a really sort of weird year. Like, this is definitely like probably the highlight of a long, I mean, I don't know how, when the last time I felt like this is a long time in the rear view.
And why, apart from the obvious, why does it feel so different to the nerves you'd get walking on stage elsewhere? I know it's an obvious one, but just try and from you and give us the vibes.
No, it's a good question. I think that when I last played shows, my whole perspective on this was completely different, because it was all just taken for granted. You know, like, I think every step of the way, like, I don't know how many shows I've played in the last 10 years. It's like in the thousands. And eventually it just changes. You just sort of have an expectation that the thing will keep on going. It'll keep on getting bigger. Everything will just feel the same. And then it just got taken away. So like, this is the first time in, I don't know how long that, like, I don't have any expectation, but like, it's been so long, so I don't know what to expect, but also so much has changed. And we are so grateful for the opportunity to perform. So it's completely flipped the dynamic and the paradigm for me. Whereas I'm not walking into this going like, I'm annoyed by this, I'm annoyed by that. Like, I'm not a diva, but like, you know what I mean? You get locked into this rhythm of it. And now the rhythm is completely gone. So it feels like we're starting again in a really strange way. Like, we're like, this is our first show, my first show. And we're kind of stepping out with this weight of expectation on us. It's very strange.
Very strange. But is there a positive too, in the sense that you can kind of almost come back with a, like, this is now how I want shows done. You know, I kind of want to have this vision. And we'll talk more, because I was just chatting to your manager there about the dynamics of the gig, not only for the people in attendance, which for you too will look quite different when you're looking out on stage, but to be dealing with a live stream.
Yeah.
You know,
I mean, listen, yeah, this is going to be like I've put more into this than I've probably put into any show. Like the biggest shows that I've ever done, I don't think I've put as much time and thought and attention in. Maybe that's because I've had a lot of time on my hands to think about this, but I also know that, like, there's a point to prove, you know what I mean? We're doing all this stuff, live streams and like pushing it as far as we can conceivably push it, because like, I obviously feel incredibly bullish about live music and what it brings to people. And I think that that's something that, like, the arts, culture in general, are so ingrained in the fabric of a country like Ireland, to almost to its detriment, because I don't think it gets talked about in the same vaulted, like, you know, terms and lofty terms that like other industries do. And it obviously had to stop, completely understand that. But we're at a point now where I'm like, we all have a point to prove. Like, very much, like, everybody in the room, like, you know, there's 9 musicians on stage. You know, I'm putting a lot of my own money and time into this, way beyond, you know, what the show is paying, because I feel like there's a massive point that needs to be proven here, which is that, like, music is vital. It gives people that cathartic moment. It gives them that opportunity to be in a field or be in a room or however many people are there and have that release of energy, have that sense of community. So doing the live stream, well, again, it's a pale comparison. We're, again, doing everything we can to try and bring as many people into this show so that they can experience it and remember what it felt like to be around people. And because, like, I've forgotten, you know, I've forgotten what it feels like to be in a crowded room. When I'm in a crowded room again, I'm sure I'll feel really strange. It's all, we're rebuilding everything. I know that sounds a bit dramatic, but it feels really true. Like, this is like a top, like, from the ground up again, rebuild of the whole process.
From you personally, then, are you, you mentioned obviously nerves, but is there, I read an article, I know you're speaking to others about this, like, this release of energy and how it's very emotional for the artist, you know, because on top of, as you said, the rebuild and all the extra work you've put into this and thinking about things differently and the last year and how emotional and, you know, the turmoil that the entire live music industry has experienced for well over a year now.
Yeah,
it almost will be a therapy for you to get back there and just release that energy again. And, like, you know, there probably will be tears.
Yeah, I think I have suffered, and I think the industry, so many people have suffered. These are such nuanced conversations, and like, every person's experience is exclusively theirs, right, through this whole year and a half. For me personally, like, I've probably had some of the darkest moments, because my energy levels were built on what I said earlier, this expectation that my life will continue the way it was supposed to continue. And then the rug was pulled out from all of us. I really struggled with that because a lot of my self-worth, a lot of my value as a person is brought from music, right? For better or worse. And to have that taken away, you suddenly start questioning everything. And also your energy levels are all over the place. This is, for these last 2 weeks, doing this has made me feel like the person I used to be for the first time in a year and a half. And that's such a beautiful thing. And I see it in everybody in the room, everybody I'm talking to. We're just like this. It's going to be emotional. I don't know what it's going to feel like. I know what it feels like in the room. Like, I had one friend of mine come in yesterday when we were rehearsing, and even having one person in the room that wasn't a part of the group, we all performed differently. It was really the strangest thing. Like, and we were like, we were performing for Mark, my friend. And
what an honor for Mark.
He was like, I feel so privileged. He was like, I get to witness this thing. And he's a musician as well. Like, and he's in the band Codeline. Mark obviously has experienced the biggest stages in the world. And he has the same perspective that I do. And he was like, I didn't know how much I missed this. What's going to happen at the show is completely unknown. I know it's going to be almost like a giant therapy session for all of us. I've been having these weird dreams about it. It's I can't sleep because I'm like, even now I've got my notepad in front of me where I'm talking about guitar changes and all these different things. It's so unknown. Just very strange, quite disconcerting, but like kind of in a lovely way.
In your dream, are you seeing Iveagh Gardens in your dreams, or is it kind of something off the wall? You know, dreams don't make sense sometimes.
I'm walking out on stage. I keep having this recurring dream where I walk out on stage because that is the greatest moment. Like, there's a lot of great moments in music, but one of the greatest ones, and I'd say a lot of musicians would say the same thing, is that moment when you walk out on stage and the crowd sees you. Like, you've been, like, when you go to a show, you know, and the lights drop and it's dark, and then the person that you're there to see.
The person in the audience starts getting the butterflies up to their stomach and the real energy kicks in. Like, yes. Yeah.
You can feel it now, right? Even as we're talking about this, like I'm getting that feeling where I'm like, yeah, like I remember being a kid and seeing like I remember going to see Ray LaMontagne in like the Village when I was a kid, and he came out on stage and I didn't even know it was him because like he was so low key. I just thought he was a guitar tech, and then he just started singing. And I have every memory of a show is of that first moment. And I've always tried to build that moment out, like really raise the level of expectation for the crowd, because for them as much as me, it's something to feed into. So I keep having this dream where like, you know, someone walks out, like the horn section go out, and then I follow behind them. And it's just that feeling of like, you know, people seeing me. And which is quite, maybe sounds a little narcissistic or whatever, but it's not, it's just that lovely feeling of like us all seeing each other. It's a beautiful thing.
It really, really is. Oh, I'm on the verge of tears now, even thinking about it. I'll be the first person on a live stream tomorrow. For those who don't know, okay, so a lot of people watching this probably weren't lucky enough to get one of the precious 500 tickets that sold out so quickly last week. How will it look for you on stage then? How is this setup going to happen, as far as you know?
Well, I mean, for us on stage, like obviously it's daytime. So like we're a little limited in what we can do. We've sort of been given these parameters to work to. Like, I guess they wanted us to play a little earlier. So it's like 8 to 9:15 or 9:30. But my lighting engineer is a genius, Connor Jacobs, and he's building something that's like kind of like a tropical wonderland. Like we've like brought in like loads of plants. And like I had a show a few years back where we had these big translucent pyramids on stage. So we've like sort of bust out all the hits. So we're trying to give ourselves something really immersive to exist in on stage, because again, it's bright, so you want to really kind of get locked in as quickly as possible. And then like in terms of the crowd, I have no idea. Like I'm going to go to site and I'll see it for the first time with everybody else, because like I don't know what it's going to look like. People are in pods and they can sit or they can stand. It's like, you know, 500 people plus like maybe 600 people all together across a big field. But hopefully it'll feel, we joke about it, because when you're starting out and you play like at 2 o'clock on a festival bill, there might not be a lot of people there, but like photographers have a really uncanny way of like getting down real low to make like 500 people look like 10,000, you know, they can get that really like a low angle. So it looks amazing. So we're like, we might just have to like hunch down a little bit to make 500 people feel like a lot more. But my suspicion is that like, they're going to be pretty noisy.
Sorry, James.
It's all good.
Is you will be able to see everyone. And that must be a strange thing too, because even if you are playing that 2 o'clock slot at the festival, you know, where people are in pods, you can almost go, oh, they're having great crack there in pod number four. Oh, pod number five, that's over this song.
We can call out anybody that's like, we're like pod 54, you look like you're having no fun. We can exactly. Yeah.
And there's James writing down his notes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Put them final in my question little black for book the new like... single Paradise. I absolutely love it. This will be your first time performing it live, I presume.
Yeah, this is it. Like, I mean, we did a couple of like live versions. We went down to Grouse Lodge and did some stuff a couple of months ago. But yeah, like there's actually like beyond that, like there's another song, Me and My Friends, that I released like 3 years ago. And when we were rehearsing it, I was like, I've never played the song live, because I released the song and then kind of took a break from playing shows. So I've never played the full band version live. So like, this is very much a night of a first for like, for me, for the band, for everybody. I've got new band members in, like, so like there's like a lot of really nice moments, like genuine first honest moments that are going to happen. So Paradise is towards the end of the set, obviously, and comes in that moment of like the bigness at the end of the show. So I'm really excited. It sounds really great in rehearsals.
James, the 500 people are the luckiest people on earth to be there with you tomorrow. You know,
a lot of pressure.
An unforgettable night, not only for you and for the people that are there and for the people watching on the stream, but for the whole live entertainment scene and gig revelers across the entire country. The very best of luck. No doubt you're going to nail it. And thank you so much for giving me your time this morning. I really appreciate it.
Absolute pleasure. Yeah, I'm really excited. I'm very nervous now. You've really built that up.
Cheers, James.